Well, mute, actually. So, Clip, she's like, hey, have you reviewed the fives? And I'm like, the what? The fives. We had the sixes, now we have the fives. And I'm like, that's the name of the speakers, the fives? And okay. And I don't do much research into it because it's Clip. You know, they're going to send me something and it's going to probably be pretty good. And then it's like, it's very small, self-powered speaker. It's a very Klipsch self-powered speaker, and it's also $800. So, I'm going to really quickly define what these speakers are. Have you ever heard of Vanatu T1 Encores? Have you heard of Canto Tux? Have you heard of the Fives? If there was like one of those, you know, murals where all the dogs are playing poker, you can completely replace that with the Canto Tux, Vanatu T1 Encores, and the Fives. Because they're all very much in the same club of 5-inch driver. I would almost want to include the Edifier S3000 Pros, but those are, because they're the same price as this, but those are 6.5. I feel like those are cheating. 5-inch drivers, DSP corrected to the 9s, subwoofer out controls, self-powered, super hyper-duper modern speaker solution. Now, Vanatu, I think, loses this competition for looks. Crazy high-end in the technology department. It's got that weird control thing, and you have all these options. The Tux were much easier to live with, both with looking at them and with the actual controls. Those are the most modern-looking speakers that have ever existed. But now, you have to consider the wood grain. Because here's my heresy force. Big Klipsch. Little Klipsch. And this is not veneer. That's not even shiny. That's just fucking wood. And oh, we've got a three-fingered slot port here, which, Jesus, fucking lights. That's the exciting speaker. Let's look at the boring speaker. So the boring speaker just has, I'm gonna pick it up. If not, I don't want to get fingerprints on it because it's too pretty. Excuse me. There's your slot port. It's the same exact port they have on all their speakers, which is actually very nice. Up top, here's your speaker connection. Main power, 60 watts. Impedance, 4 ohms, which doesn't matter because you're plugging into an extension wire. Just look at the finish on this. Like, I feel like they didn't finish it at the factory. Oh, by the way, cork on the bottom. They just have a very thin layer of cork so that you can put it down on a hard surface and it doesn't get damaged. And if for nothing else, you could buy these as a stress relief ball because, oh my God, like the actual shimmer of the wood changes with the light for every stroke of the grain. It's wild. And I kind of want to get out some lacquer and finish this speaker. And then it comes with the tweed grills, which actually I have one complaint about these. They're a little bit loose. Like they don't tighten it up that much. There's another speaker grill. Like even these are, those are like guitar strings or something you get on a tennis racket. And this is a little bit like, a little bit loosey-goosey. So if I had to like complain, I'd say that, and it doesn't affect the sound, you just see it moving. Unless they did that on purpose. You know what? I'll bet you any amount of money, not really, but I'll bet you any amount of money that they left this loose so that it flexed, because if I made it too tight, it would do weird things to the sound. Because this is very purposefully left like that. And trust me, there's going to be excursion in a few minutes that I will show you. That's going to be like, oh, of course, that's why they did that. It just came to me. So I'm going to take the covers off. And I do think that with the covers on, they are a handsome fucking set of speakers. Like absolutely just charming. Not very wide. They're a very narrow, very pretty. Have we even talked about these top controls? Because if you haven't seen them, those are metal knobs. Like literally metal knobs. Oh, I have it muted. That's still playing. Must do some stuff with buttons. Gotta pause the music so that I could unmute this. And then you can see me touch my knobs, or the fives knob. It says the fives with a funky, like, I'm trying to think where that font would be from. Like a 50s retro diner. the Fives at Avalon. Get your burgers here or something. I don't know. But these are metal knurled knobs, and you can see the volume indicator here is just dimming every individual LED. So I don't even know how many steps there are, honestly. I didn't count. So if we get... Okay, so we're going to turn this second one on, this analog one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 11, 12. 12. So each one of these is 12 steps of volume, and you have to, like... Unfortunately, you have to touch this beautiful metal knob. There's a problem with the knobs, and it might just be my unit, but if I push it from the side, it hits and just barely scrapes. But if you just go straight up. Now I have a, it will light up all the way to the absolute maximum. And these LEDs are not just the volume LEDs, TV, Bluetooth, optical, USB, analog, and phono. Those are your source selectors. So we scroll this down to where I like the volume. You can just literally go, boop, looking for Bluetooth, boop, TV, which we have to talk about the back of the speaker, phono, analog, USB, and back to optical. There's no on-off button on this. And I was like, how do I turn it on without the remote? Because I have the remote. We'll talk about the remote. I have the remote, and I'm like, I want to turn this on. Because when you it'll go to sleep at night, and or you could hit power here. Literally, there's a power. Did I hit power? There we go. Power. No lights. And I'm like, all right, it's off. Like, there's no main circuit. So just wiggle. On. How perfect is that? How perfect is that? They didn't have to add an extra button. They just monitor what the source selector is doing. If the source selector goes, it comes back on. That's brilliance by design, because where the fuck would you put a button? You wouldn't be able to put a nice enough button, all right, to match the metal on metal on metal, so that's great. There are some issues with the controls all being on top. It's perfectly fine here, me standing in my living room. But, like, as if you're, like, controlling the volume, it's a wonderful indicator here, like, literally here. But if I were to go, say, here, well, fuck. There's not even an indicator on the front to say it's on. I will give them a pass because beauty is probably going to be an important factor if you're spending $800. And, you know, you could get a mirror and just sort of like mount a mirror up there because you just want to see all the angles of these fucking speakers. So I think I've explored the top of this. That's it. You got it? Good. Remote control. Power, which I just demonstrated. Play pause, which I believe will function through the USB and the Bluetooth. Possibly the TV. We'll get to the TV input. It's important. It's never seen before in a speaker. Sort of shit. Well, maybe Bluetooth, like soundbars. Volume up and down with mute. When you mute, it simply blinks the top. Again, an indication you will not see if you're sitting below the unit. Because, I mean, like here, it's fine. Like here, it's fine. I can still see it. I can even still see it now. It's starting to go away, and I can't see it. So as long as you can see the top of the speaker, you're fine. Unmute. Sub down, sub up. Sub reset. TV, Bluetooth, auxiliary, USB, phono, optical. So just basically pick your... These are all to pick the source. Because you can't see the top. And if you want to pick auxiliary, just jump to it without having to scroll through. We'll hook up a sub. I think we'll hook this sub up to it. Does that sound good, ladies and gentlemen? I think we'll hook the Rhythmic 15 Zeos. Link to the Rhythmic 15 in the description. I actually do have a 15-inch clip sub, but it's packed up and I'm moving, so I'm not going to unpack it. Where were we? Oh, we were probably playing music. I like that music stuff. You ever hear that? Oh. Gentle. Light. Horn. Now, I will admit, I have sort of become a Klipshorn guy in the last few months. Acquiring the Heresy 4s has sort of like oofed me towards this sound, towards what this can do. And when the horn is bigger than the driver, by the way, very light scroll of Klipsch there. The same speckled front as, do you have this? Oh, this could rip my finger. It's fine. See, this is fine. It's fine. Mm. Yeah. You have a more of an orange peel. Oh, let's take you off just because I want to see you again. So horns, little horns, little baby driver, oh fuck. So there we go. Is this in the back? I've seen this clip patterning before. No, but same spot on the bottom. Here's your infrared receiver. Not a light. I thought it was gonna be a power LED and I'm like, that's gonna suck. It's not. No exposed hardware, paper cone, very, very firm paper cone. You're gonna wanna brush this out. There's that clip showing. Not rubberized like I like it on their like RP, is there RP600M rubberized? I think it is. The 150M started, I think everything in the M series. This is a hardened one, but I think they fixed what that was fixing because it's DSP correction. I'm gonna point at the Swan D1090s. Just point at them, that's all I'm gonna do. I'm not gonna say another fucking word, just. And then we're gonna go back to these speakers which are twice the price. But we have to talk about DSP because there's no fucking way, no way, a 5 1/4 in a box this size, and it's not a giant box, it's not a big box, can do the low end things this do. And I'm talking about with a sub, I'm talking about on its own. I'm gonna shuffle a little bit because, you know, Zeos is nothing if not spontaneous. That's Tron Legacy reconfigured NCOM part 2, the COM Trues remix. Let's just go to like the regular. Get Lucky, no. Giorgio. Random Access Memories is here. Well, give me a good one. Yell louder at the screen. I would love to play more, but you know, I'd like to eventually monetize some videos, and it's, thank you for supporting me on Patreon and Subscribestar, because fuck, you know what? Fuck monetization. These speakers sound so much bigger than they are. And it has to be, because I understand a bit about it. It's not because, oh, this 5 1/4 is obviously amazing. No. I might have put the remote down, stop. They are DSP correcting the living shit. Out of them. To a that port in the back is just flailing air out of it. How do I demonstrate that real quick? Perfect. This is the IRS pay stubs I've got to send into the state. Isn't this fantastic how science works? It damaged it. It damaged my IRS pay stub. Now you gotta support me on Patreon because holy fuck. It doesn't make any sense how much violence is in these. But that being said, where the Vanitu T1 Encores will sort of like prevent you from getting anywhere near the point where failure will occur, and even the Canto Tux with their slot port, you turn them up and up and up and they never quite fail. You can push these too hard. They Klipsch doesn't know what level of volume you're playing. By the way, I remember running this off of a fiber optic cable in case you didn't know. It's just coming out of my computer. It's actually taking a very, very roundabout route to get here, but we won't discuss that because it's playing uncompressed FLAC from FUBAR straight into it. And I have a FUBAR up all the way, so that's my source. And if I go past, yeah, I'm at 4 full light bars, and that one is just on with like 3 clicks. Any more than that, and you will bottom out this driver. So you have to be at least considerate of the feelings of the fives. Now, if you don't want to be considered about the feelings of the fives, then it's when you bring the wire here over. That's when you do, I'll put this in my pants. Putting things in my pants. Actually, before I do the real deal, let me show you what it actually happens. This is a RCA cable. Actually, these are the $10 ones I recommend. They're really nice. They're super flexible for 10 bucks with like springy connectors. I'm gonna unpause. Let me see. I hope the grid game has changed. The Crystal Method Remix from the Tron Reconfigured doesn't get me super pulled from the YouTube, because then I have to redo this and I hate that. I'm just going to unpause this, let the song start, then plug this into the subwoofer out. We'll look at the back of this in a second, actually. Hold on. There's, if you didn't couldn't tell, there's a very, very high bass drop. Bass is no longer part of the equation. Because as smart as these speakers are, they can't tell a sub is not there. They can just tell you a wire is plugged in. See, now they sound like, these now sound like I'd imagine a 5-inch would sound, a little bit light. Like, ooh, it's trying. You're so cute, honey. You're trying. It's okay. We'll just lower your price from 800 to like 500, and then you'll make sense. But then, man, do they open up when you actually let them have it. Let's put that down. Let's put that down. Let's take this one apart. See, I don't think you could shut this off remote, like without the remote. That's another thing. I think it's just like you leave it alone. It doesn't get hot. There's no off button. Hello? All right, we're going to take the fiber optic out. We're going to unplug the power. We're going to disconnect the speaker wire going to the other speaker, which is one of these four pins, which means that they're controlling each driver individually, which is good. It's what you want to see. It's where the Canto Toxalact versus the Vanitu. Vanitu has a crazy, like, 10-pin Cat 7 cable or something that it runs several of those for the tweeter and several for the woofer, and that's how it brings its control to the other side. The Canto Tox are just speaker wire, so it's just using a normal speaker on that side and just feeding it power, and there is DSP correction, but it still has to rely on splitting the thing up with a crossover. This, like the Swans and like other powered monitors, is just completely saying, I'm controlling you, I'm controlling you, I'm controlling you, and I'm controlling you, and I'll tell you exactly what the fuck to do and when. So that's why you want to see one of those four pin. Now, I can actually lay this down on its face because everything is tucked pretty well in there. Again, that nice cork. Let's just get to the gorilla of the room. There's an HDMI port on this called HDMI ARC. And that is audio return channel. And that is something you'd really only see on like a soundbar from Samsung. Because that's the most home theater friendly connection you can get. Now, I don't know how it would work specifically with only one. My thought would be that you'd run, like you'd have to have your TV, which is set up thin and beautifully. You'd have to have your TV, get your sources, and then you'd have to have an ARC output into this. So I guess instead of having a surround receiver, because this isn't generating your signal, you'd have to have all your signals in and then have the ARC output of your TV into this, and then that becomes a TV output. It's obviously not going to handle surround sound, but that's another way to hook it up to your television. I've never seen that before. You've got a USB service port. You get a primary left or right switch. I set it up primary left because my fiber optic cable only has to go to here. Otherwise, some speakers, this is where the primary has to be, and then you have to either switch left and right RCAs, or fuck around in FUBAR to make left and right switch, or if you have a good speaker, and the Vanitus will do this, the Tux will do this, and these will do this. Very different methods to swap it, but it's just literally like, you're the primary right, you're the primary left. If you put it into Bluetooth mode, there is a pair button. I did try to put it in the mode and it just started blinking and it didn't show up on my phone. You reach back here, you press that, boom, the 5 shows up. We have got our phono or line input. And it's that because you've got a ground terminal here for your turntable, your left and right inputs, and you have a switch that says line or phono. And this is Klipsch. If you can get a pair of these into like someone who's really like old school, if you can fool them, this would be the greatest gift ever. Hey, Dad, I got you some old, I got you an old pair of Klipp speakers. Sneak the fives into their living quarters. You could hook up some stuff, hook the phono up to it. It'll blow their fucking minds. So there you go. You have the auxiliary, which is a 3.5 millimeter, which is a separate control in there. Here's our subwoofer out. You got optical input. You got your USB input, which I haven't hooked these up USB. I don't believe it's going to give you any extra features. It's just USB. And then you get nothing except for the ground, the other speaker terminal, and your figure eight power. Anything else interesting back here? Nope, just that port. I don't know what it is about this port. I wish it was something I could install into that. Oh, I could see, look how big the magnet is in that fucking tweeter. Holy shit. It's like that big for the, oh. All right, I'm putting you back together. It's a nice solid piece. And when you're holding it in your hands, like you could tell it's made of wood. It's not made of like, ah, oh, just whatever. Like this feels like I expected it to feel. This is new. This is a new type of thing. I feel like if you got this wet by accident, it'd be the worst thing ever though. Like you don't want to mess up and accidentally spill red wine on this, or it's you just have red wine. Just pour the whole red wine on it. Try to match the whole thing. So we need that, we need this, and we need my fiber optic, which is my favorite connection because it doesn't require drivers or doesn't give a shit, and boom. Arise, chicken, arise. It blinks a few times, then it says, okay, I'm working. And we come back here, and then we hit next track. I shifted it to USB. When I did the thingy, we're gonna go up one. There we go. What's our volume at? Oh, when you unplug the power, this is something that's probably not gonna involve most people, but if you disconnect the power completely, it resets the volume down, which is probably a good thing. So I'm just gonna put that back to where I like it. If you wanna do that with the remote, why do I keep turning around? Nothing's behind me. I'm behind you. You see how fast you can run up and down through the volume by just holding the button, which is nice. But of course you're gonna want, they work on a desk. I'll give them this, they work on a desk. They are lacking something, however, and it's something that the other two I was talking about do have, and that's bass and treble control. There are no bass and treble controls. Cantor Tux, right on the remote, bass and treble. The Vanatu T1 Encores, big fucking knobs, bass and treble. This speaker expects you to deal with it in the space. If it has too much bass, too bad. Move it further away from the wall. Not enough bass, move it towards the wall. Still not enough bass, plug in a giant subwoofer. We'll do that in a second. Let me go back to, oh God, Blade Runner 2049. All right. I don't want to break the speakers, but, and I'm going to give this as a warning to people who are watching this video and have made it more than like, I don't know, what are we in, like 11 minutes? From the Blade Runner 2049 soundtrack, Blade Runner 2049, the song 2049, will damage speakers. I don't know why, but it has enough gain to break something. So I'm gonna lower this down because I don't really feel like paying clips for these right now with current purchases in order. And I'm gonna just play it and we're gonna see if I can, well, play it. All right. Yeah, look at that. Look at that baby go. And that's at like a whisper. There's so much anger inside of this. You know, that's at such a low volume, it's barely making sound. You put this up, actually, I know what we're doing. We're gonna plug that in, aren't we? Yeah, we are. Pause. Let's take the red one. This is just the longest set of RCAs I have. And we're just gonna plug you in here. Whoop. Might be beneficial if you don't have that on when you do that initial plug-in, because you might get a blurp. Let's back this up. And now I'm not going to raise the volume. Oh, lords. literally things just around it are rattling. Like that view? Yeah, it's hooked up to the mini DSP that does, oh. My whole world is rattling over there. So now we can raise the volume and rely on that, like a $1,000 subwoofer, to take over the low end. Now with the sub, plus, and minus buttons, you can tone that sub down. Just tone it down, or reset, or tone it up. Whoa! Full bars. Oh, yeah, no, reset, reset. No, bad. It tones it up a lot. So just, I would recommend highly, do not just go nonchalantly just turn this up. See, is this gonna be loud? It's gonna be louder. It's gonna be louder. We pinned red, and I think my bathroom door just fell off its hinges. So they give you a lot of leeway with this sub. I love the reset button. You're gonna need that. Reset seems to do good. Set your sub. If you want a little more bass, go click, play it. A little less bass, reset, lower. Okay, good. But really, I'm not here to demonstrate it with a subwoofer. Although, this is from Claymore. This is Shokai. Although, when you do plug it into a sub, and it's the same, again, the Vanitus, the Tux, and the Fives will all remove the low end from the speaker itself, which is impeccably important. Because the whole reason you add a sub is not just to, I want more bass. You want to take the burden of bass off the speaker. And with only a 5 1/4, and you saw how well it works, and you saw it moving that thing, if you want more, you got to take the responsibility away. And that's what plugging this in does. That's what it does in all three of those speakers. Takes the responsibility of the low end away, and now you get more volume. So we could actually blast it. So, I mean, that's not exact. That is...
be an American idiot.
I'm pretty sure I can't play Richard Cheese because that's just the end of the fucking blocked. Blocked worldwide. But hopefully if I didn't edit it just now, that was Richard Cheese. If I did edit it, that was fucking Richard Cheese. And I love that man, but he needs to hire better, different lawyers. Joe Walsh in the City from the Warriors soundtrack. And it's like we're getting... Yeah, these don't sound like a little 5-inch. I mean, they're $800. That, I gotta say it again, because I think it's important that you understand. Where did the volume end up? Just a little bit higher than my like. Thank you, subwoofer. So if you ever decide to buy an $800 set of extremely pretty speakers, like just extraordinarily classy as fuck. And I think there's different finishes. I have a page open. This is black and this. And if you get just black, stop. Just like, They're the same price. It's not like you're paying extra for this. If you decide to buy these and it just comes down to the fact that you're like, you know what? I really wish they had a little bit more volume and a little bit more low end. Just get any subwoofer. It doesn't have to be a $1,000 Rhythmic, although that wouldn't hurt. And just plop it down in the middle. And plug in a wire, and then you have controls, how much, how little. Although I would say, just like the Vanitu, the real party piece of these speakers is how much low end they throw completely on their own. We've gone a little bit soft now. Oh yeah. Incubus. I should probably talk about what their overall sound is like. They have the Klipsch House sound. They sound like a big old horn. They image spectacularly. Like I've been doing speaker sound demos now, like day after day. And the T8Vs I liked. And then I did those ELACs, and they were $600 for those ELACs, and they're 6.5, and they were a fancy tweeter, and I just hated them. They had nothing for me. And then these now, before the Swans, those are the last ones I'm gonna do, but these have really fucking like No. They hold their own at $800. Look, I can't tell you what's expensive anymore, all right? I've lost my way. I've lost my way. So if you're watching this and you're going, $800, Zios, that's stupid. And meanwhile, I'm sitting here going, fuck, you can do this with $800? This is a conflict of interest. Because I wouldn't normally, like, here's the thing. The sixes exist. But the sixes were an older speaker. It's what other speaker did that where they literally completely upgraded it and it's like, holy shit, this is so much better than the old one. Like, it's not even funny. I never got a chance to hear the sixes, but from what I've heard, people who have heard them and have heard the fives, these fives are itching for a bigger set because the sixes currently go for like $1,500. So you take an $800 speaker with a 5 1/4. You make everything they're doing with DSP correction and connectivity options and that finish and the look, and then you bump it up a little bit, you absolutely have a $1,200 to $1,500 speaker here. Because I can't believe that this speaker is doing it for this. Like, the only thing that I found is that volume wall that you can go past. That's the only, it doesn't handhold you in the higher volumes.
Hark, hear the bells, sweet silver bells,
all seem to say ding dong K.
Christmas is here.
Like, I'm not one to just like, well, I am one to shill the shit out of something, but I'm also not one to lie, because this permanent record thing called a video, and anyone who buys these, who says, hey, that guy Zio said those are great, they're terrible, I'm gonna go complain in his comments. Look, whatever year it is, it's 2020 currently. Did we all survive it? Wonderful. Look at the comments in 2021. Has anyone who bought these or heard them been absolutely anything but impressed? Because I'm impressed. They made such a small speaker. Narrower than the Tux, narrower than the Vanitus. You know what? I don't even think it's a 5 1/4. How fucking weird is that? These are called the fives. I don't think that's a 5 1/4. That might be a 5. And yet it can belt out Mr. Mackey's Carol of the Bells like no one's business. I'm becoming a huge, like, everyone gets tattoos. And I know DMS has got one that's like a circuit of like a tube amp. And it's like, that's cute. I would get a full-on back tattoo that's just a DSP chip and all the connectors for it. Because DSP is going to be a fucking tour de force in the next few years. It's already happened. It's already happening. There is no way, no way. You listening to me, DIY builders? You listening to me? Good? There's no fucking way you, anybody watching this who DIY speakers, and I put this challenge out. You could send me a set when you're done and you've finished. That you can build a speaker with a 5-inch driver and a horn and without a full fuck DSP correction, make it sound this good. You can't do it. There's no amount of crossover tweaking and tweening and, oh, I put this resistor on this direction, so it won't work. It won't work because whatever these drivers are picked specifically, and then whatever final adjustments need to be made are made in a land of ones and zeros. And these are amazing sounding speakers. Not just a good 5 1/4. These shit on, like, everything else passive that looks anything like this. All the whole lower end clip stuff. Like RP150M? No. Because this, they're being forced to behave by the DSP. And I can't, like, that low end, I don't know how many decibels they're adding to certain frequencies at certain volumes when they get a certain signal, but it's perfectly tuned for the box. Helegoland. Oh, this is actually, I can go to Doomsday. Is Doomsday good or Bass Trap? Bass Trap?
Let the bass line get
you. Nah, Doomsday. Like, the horn at this volume, it sounds like a clip horn. Like, you're going to want to tone it down. I wouldn't want to be on a desk with this sort of volume. But in this room, which is not a small room, Like, the heresies fill the room, but these do a damn fine job of getting as close to the heresies as possible. Never. That's the one that has the low end. Here we go. See, I feel like we're getting right at that line. Yeah, I'm creeping into the fifth dot. If you're under the fifth dot, at least for my signal and my music, you never think anything's wrong. As soon as you get a little past it. And that's a little bit quieter now. It's a little bit quieter, but it's taking that low end. It'll go against the wall. By the way, low end hits the wall and stays here. It bounces back. So if you want the most low end, you would literally put your back to the wall and then play speakers in front of you. Up against the wall, motherfuckers. Okay, actually, that's the line in that song. Holy shit. What are the odds of that? I didn't even. I'm gonna put their covers back on because, frankly, I don't think they're ugly with the covers on either. I mean, I leave my Heresy covers on and then I take them off. And then I put them on and then I take them off because I can't decide what I like better. Because if you do a good job on your cover, you get the best of both worlds. You get to take them off and put them on and put them on and take them off. Every other speaker on earth, these swans, they have covers. But who fucking wants to put that on? Like, you want to see it, but now it's like, where's my remote? God damn it, keep losing things. Anyway, one last little,
I came in the building. I just wanted something better for me and my children.
Hope you could see that on camera. I think that movement is specifically why they left those loose. So it just moves with the air instead of trying to fight it. What, if that's the case, if I figured that out, they're brilliant. And hee-ho to 2020 Klipsch Engineering. We're playing the whole thing I just said, like the entire 33 minutes, 34 minutes. Where are we at? In my head. And I know I didn't talk about, well, what about all the things that speaker reviewers talk about, Zeos, when they talk about the clarity and the imaging? If I'm this excited about a speaker, you don't have to fucking worry about it. Everything you're thinking about is great. I will point out a flaw instantaneously. But when something's fantastic, I mean, I can only shill so hard before it turns into like hyper shill mode. And you're like, well, why is he talking about it like exuberantly, like it's chocolate orgies? What? Who even says that? I do. I saw chocolate orgies. The only speaker that has a more impressive DSP correction are those swans. And those are a 6.5. And those are half the price. And I wasn't going to talk about them, but they're coming up next. I've removed them from my life so that I could get every other speaker out of the way and then talk about those. And I won't know till, well, after the sound demo I do on these, if those would be the recommendation over these. They certainly don't have the feature set of these, not even close. And they certainly don't have the looks. Sorry, Swan. These are exactly what you want in your office in Midtown Manhattan, or in Great Neck, Ohio, or in, oh, Chewbacca's here. I gotta give her medicine. That's right, it's medicine time. So I'm gonna wrap it up because my cat's more important than any review. I know, go open your box. Support me on Patreon and Subscribestar. Download that wallpaper. I give these a full fuck recommendation, and not just because I love Klipsch. But because they deserve it. Hi, baby. You go here. We'll play with subwoofers later. That wallpaper, which represents the beauty and narrowness of these speakers, is available in the description. All wallpapers are available on Patreon and Subscribestar. You get to see all these reviews on Patreon and Subscribestar weeks ahead of time. You get to discuss them with your peers on there. You get to ask me any questions you want on platform. And you get to enter the yard sale. If Klipsch was like, hey, we're just going to give you these fives, and I didn't, for whatever reason, want to keep them, which would be stupid. I'd absolutely want to keep them. It wouldn't even be a fucking question. They're too pretty. These are like the opposite type of pretty as a tux. The tux are very modern and new, and these are old school AF, yet clean. Like, it's just, my whole brain hurts. I feel like Vanity needs to do a real major update to their looks to even fight with those two. Where'd she disappear to? Oh. These would be in like the yard sale, which happens from the 1st to the 10th of every month. You've heard the yard sale spiel so many times. So things that I get, companies send me, I buy, people donate to the channel, get sold in the yard sale, 1st to the 10th. If you're in the continental United States, I ship for free. If you're international, it's half shipping. So you want something that's never been available in your country, and I've reviewed it, and I'm putting it for sale, I'll ship it to you. It's just you pay half the shipping. And whatever you bid, you have to outbid the Americans. She's just everywhere now. Oh, no, that's not. That's very unstable. That's super unstable, boo-boo. Why? Just like I am, super unstable. So that's the $5 tiers. The $10 tier gets you into a private behind-the-scenes Telegram chat, which puts you in a room with 200 people that are not even like-minded. That's the thing. There's lots of opinions, and most of them are good. And I'm in there, and I'll answer any question you want with my voice, and that'll be that. Check out our Hi-Fi Guides and the Hi-Fi Guide forums. These will definitely be on Hi-Fi Guides for like powered speakers. There's no question. They're too good. They're too remarkably good with a 5-inch. It's not even a 5 1/4. I'm pretty sure it's a 5-inch. They're just too fucking good. And then the forums will have a dedicated official post where you can go and post your own reviews or find other people's reviews or find internal diagrams, have discussions, and hey, has anyone modded these to have bigger MOSFETs? It's like that's the place to be, is the Hi-Fi Guides forum. She's fine. Okay, and yeah, sound demo in the description, which I'm going to do the sound demo now. The mics are out. I'll drag them in. I'll put my air conditioner back on for about 20 minutes because it's starting to get warm in here. And you'll see that video tomorrow or in the description below. Are we good? Chewbacca, are we good? She says we're good. Anyway, I'll see you tomorrow. Thanks for stopping by.